It should be clear that news in the media are derived from a small group of plaintiffs that harbor animosity and have ill intentions. Forced confessions with defaming and accusatory statements against Mr. Oktar are fictional, untrue statements. No evidence supporting any of the accusations. The published list of indictment confirms this. All rape accusations false, proven by the 6th Forensic Specialization Board. Drug accusations false, proven by the Forensic Chemical Specialization Board. Paintings and sculptures found in homes are not of historical or ancient value, as proven by the expert reports issued by Mimar Sinan Faculty of Fine Arts. There is no rape tape. Alleged fortune claimed to be buried under the properties, false. Government officials have excavated every inch of all the properties. Military and political espionage accusations, false. No proof. Captivity and enslavement accusations, false. Since a police raid was conducted simultaneously on 120 different properties. Torture and torment accusations, false. No proof offered by the accusers. All weapons were registered with licenses, legal and clean, as proven by the ballistic analysis conducted by Istanbul Criminal Police Lab Directorate. No evidence of threats or blackmail against anyone, despite all phones being taped by officials for the last 2 years. No proof of money laundering, as all companies paid their bills per normal course of business. A9 TV and global publishing companies don't have hundreds of millions of dollars to launder, as claimed, but rather had a modest budget. Even the list of indictments does not include such accusations. Despite all these undeniable facts, some bloggers are trying to manipulate the public opinion through fictitious news and false propaganda methods, knowing that their plot will fail due to lack of tangible evidence.